everybody, and welcome back to another Gal tutorial. I hope you guys are doing well at home, and I hope that this tutorial provides some creativity and fun during this time. So today I'm going to show you how you can take a sketch, a pencil sketch, and transform it into a high-res vector that you can then put in any product mock-up or print designs that you're working on. No fancy tablets are needed. You can even just use an IKEA pencil, that's what I was using, and just trace it with any marker around the house. And there's a really cool app that you can use to capture and then send it to Photoshop. So I'm going to show you how to do all of that. But before we jump in, I want to thank Hover for sponsoring this video. I've talked about Hover before. It's a great place to go shopping for creative domains. So if you're looking for a cool extension like .art, .design, and even popular right now, .live, you can get all your extensions there and connect them to your favorite website builder. Now I'm going to talk more about Hover later in this video, but for now you can go ahead and use my link in the description to get 10% off your domain. Let's go ahead and jump on in. So after you're done sketching out your logo with a pencil, you can further define the lines using a fine tip or a brush marker. And once that's done, you can erase any remaining pencil sketches around the outline so that way it's nice and clean. Next, this is where the magic happens. Download the Adobe Capture app on your phone. It's a free photo to vector converter app for iOS and Android. You'll see here that there are many different things you can capture: materials, type, shapes, colors, looks, patterns, and brushes. But for this, we're going to choose shape. And as you prepare to take the photo, you can move this slider here to choose how much detail you want to capture. Then, rather than hitting capture, you can tap the auto clean icon here up at the top to get a cleaner shot. Then you can hit the check mark, and from here you can refine, crop, and smooth. Let's first crop the image down just by adjusting the crop rectangle. And now this is my favorite part, the smoother. Just turn on smoothing, and it will start to smooth out all of the lines so it's more clean. And then hit save, and it will create a .svg, a scalable graphics vector that you can then directly send to Illustrator or Photoshop on your computer. So let's send it to Photoshop because I want to further refine edges and color it in Photoshop. So after you hit send to Photoshop, it actually auto opens up Photoshop on your computer. So here you can give this project a name, adjust the resolution. If you want to use this logo for print in the future, make sure to keep it at a 300 DPI resolution and then just hit OK. So now you can see we have a transparent background with our sketch. And now you can zoom in around the lines just to make sure everything's smooth and there's no marks around the edges that you need to erase. And if you just want it to be a black outline version, you can go up to File, Export As, .cvg file, and you're done. But I actually want to add in some color here. So first, let's copy our original layer by dragging it down to the new icon, and it will duplicate it. Then turn off the original layer's visibility. The reason I copy the original layer here is to preserve it in case we ever want to go back. Now let's select the paint bucket tool by hitting G on our keyboard, and I'll choose a yellow orangish color. And let's fill in the color here between the lines and fill in the rays above the light bulb. Next, I'll choose a bright blue color for the bulb and I'll fill it in with the paint bucket. So now we have our full color logo and we can go to File, Export As, .cvg and save this. Another option, if you prefer to work in the true vector space in Illustrator, you can actually turn off the visibility of this colored version. And let's go back to the black version. Just command click on the little icon here of the black version or control click if you're on a PC, and this will load up the selection of the entire graphic. Then select M for the rectangular marquee tool and right click directly on the selection and select make work path. Be sure to set the tolerance to 1 pixel and then hit OK. And now as you zoom in, you can see that it's now a path with points. Now we can actually go up to File, Export Paths to Illustrator. And from here, just make sure to have work path selected, then hit OK. And now you can open up this AI file inside of Illustrator. So now it looks all white, but if you toggle down on your layers and you select these different layers, you can see it was the path that was exported, not the color. And you can select any one of these paths and you can add color to it. Now, if we want to use the same sort of color scheme as before, we can actually go back to Photoshop and from the Libraries panel, we can create a new color scheme from the previous color image that we made. So just click on the plus icon, then Create from Image. And then you can select color theme from the top and it will auto-generate a whole theme for you, which is really cool. And then just save it to your Creative Cloud libraries. Now back to Illustrator, when we select one of these paths we want to color, just go to the libraries panel and here you can see our newly captured theme. And just click on the color you want to apply and bam, it applied the color to that path. And then just continue to select the parts of the graphic that you want to color and click on the color theme color from the library that you want to fill it in with. And that's pretty much it. And then to scale down the graphic to fit inside of your artboard, just lasso and select the entire graphic and hit shift and scale it down until it fits into frame. Now the reason why I prefer this method is because you can see that as I zoom in here, there's no pixelation at all. It's a true vector. If we go back to the Photoshop vector path, you can see that as we zoom in, pixelation occurs. Now it's still a very high quality graphic that you can print with, and there's nothing wrong with this Photoshop.cvg that we exported. And the reason why I showed you both ways is because not everyone has access to Photoshop and Illustrator. So it's possible to make a .cvg in Photoshop, but to get an absolute true vector, I recommend using the Illustrator method. And once your vector graphic is ready, you can then use that to create product mockups for all of your different clients. And I have a whole list of great product mockups that you can use to easily place your logo on shirts, on pencils, on notebooks, on backpacks, whatever you need, I have it linked below. So that's all there is to turning your sketch into a vector graphic. I hope you guys found it useful, and if it did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more tips. I'd love to also see what logos you were able to create using the techniques I showed you in this tutorial. Please send me your designs on my Instagram at premier_gal. And now here's more about Hover. It's a great place to go shopping for a variety of different domains, whether you need it for more tech-related stuff, for your company, or for your own creative portfolio. So if you guys are a photographer, you can say carlosgonzalez.photography or .photos. You can even get different websites with .design or .art, and you can see that there are ongoing sales, so you can compare the different prices, which one you might get a better deal versus others. So that may dictate what type of extension you end up getting. Also really hot right now is live streaming, and they actually have a huge sale on .live domains. So if you're looking to promote your live streams and have a specific URL .live, you can purchase that and get an additional 10% off with my discount code. So thank you, Hover, for supporting this channel, and let me know what you guys want to learn next. I look forward to reading it in the comments below. That's it. Stay safe, everyone. See you next time. Bye.